Governor Babagana Umara Zulum started his engagement for the month of March with a walking visit to Malumpoturi, the headquarters of Abadam local government, to reassess arrangement of the resettlement committee ahead of repatriation of displaced persons to their homes. Governor Zulum inspected the 1,000 temporary shelters constructed for the returnees to occupy before their houses are fully reconstructed and directed for the immediate rebuilding of 5 blocks of classrooms at the Central Primary School, rehabilitated the healthcare center as well as the Jumad Masjid around the old cattle market, all in Malumpoturi.
The level of work done so far in Malumpoturi, that will ensure the return of the community. We have seen the temporary houses have been completed by the Ministry for RRR, and then the ongoing clearance exercise is almost completed. So our aim is to see how we can support the communities. We want to empower them. This is another package that has been developed by the government of Borno State. We want to empower them, so we shall be providing some financial assistance, financial grants to the community so that they can rebuild their homes by themselves. In addition to this one, the establishment of civil authorities is also very important.
He expressed satisfaction with the committee's work preparatory to the return of internally displaced and refugees taking shelter from border towns of Niger Republic since 2014, stressing that the 500 household returnees will be supported with 100,000 naira cash each. Professor Babagana Umara was also at the 68th Battalion Military Base in Malumpoturi to identify their needs with a view to addressing them.
I give appreciation to the theater commander, to the sector commander, as well as your brigade commander, for all the good works that they have been doing with a view to re-establishing this ancient town of Malumpoturi. So the 10 vehicles will be provided to you. In addition to this one, we shall provide additional 10 to civilian KTM and tanks.
Also in the month of March, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum was in Abuja for the inaugural meeting of the Presidential Committee on the Repatriation, Return and Resettlement of Displaced Persons in the Northeast, recently constituted by President Muhammadu Buhari. The committee is to fast-track safe return of displaced Nigerians, mostly from Borno and other states in the Northeast, with the Vice President Professor Yemi Osinbajo as Chairman and Governor Zulum as Vice Chairman of the committee. The Vice President urged members of the committee to ensure urgency, wide representation for the committee to deliver, taking into account the mandate concerning their assignment. Similarly, during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umara was in Dikwa town on a humanitarian intervention to the people affected by the over a decade-long insurgency. 40,000 households were given food and non-food items, including textile materials to women, as they prepare for the next cropping season for a sustainable means of livelihood. Governor Zulum, who supervised the distribution of food and non-food items to a combined number of 40,000 households that comprised of 24,000 women and 16,000 men, where each of the women received a textile material and 5,000 naira cash, amounting to the total of 120 million naira, which each of the men received 25 kilograms of rice and 25 kilograms of maize. While in Dikwa, the governor assessed critical public services and directed the immediate construction of a mega-sized Islamic school to meet the needs of the community.
Last year, they couldn't have unfettered access to their farmlands. Most of their products destroyed by killer bats. That necessitated the intention of the government of Borno State to come and provide them with food and non-food items. In addition to this one, we're constructing a mega Islamic school that will ensure reintegration of those that have the Quranic and Islamic background into the formal educational system.
Similarly, in the month of March, Professor Babagana Umara inaugurated the chairman and members of the newly established Borno State Sangay and Arabic Board at Council Chamber of the Government House. The new board has Khalifa Ahmad Abul Fati as chairman, Alhaji Ali Kaka executive secretary, and the members were drawn from the three senatorial districts of Borno. Addressing the board members, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum assured of adequate funding that will ensure real transformation of the Arabic and Sangaya system of education for better.
Sangaya educational system has been in existence for centuries, long before even the advent of Western education in Borno State. We established this board in order to enhance the establishment and performances of Sangayas and Islamia schools in Borno State. We want to use this board, among others, to see how we shall inculcate discipline in our own society.
Professor Babagana Umara observed that Arabic language creates an enabling environment for acquiring Western education with ease, stressing that his administration will provide the necessary learning materials required. Also, during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum, in company of ambassadors of Germany and Sweden to Nigeria, UN Humanitarian Coordinator and UNDP team, inspected 360 resettlement housing project in Garanam village of Mafa Luku government area. The project is a complete resettlement package constructed by UNDP with funding from regional stabilization facility partners, consisting of two-bedroom houses with solar light, water facility, police station, school and market. Professor Zulum thanked the donor partners for their support to the government and people of Borno State, saying the housing intervention will go a long way in complementing the state government reconstruction and resettlement drive.
Mafa was completely destroyed. About 100 people were killed in the town on that period. People left and deserted the town completely until last 2 years back. People have returned. So I think this project, you can see the number of people that came out to receive us. It's a matter of great concern to all of us. I think the government and people of Mafa and indeed of Borno State are very happy to see such kind of projects. After the completion of this project, thousands of people will benefit, the area will be secured, and this area is an agrarian place where many of the communities that are staying here will also benefit. So I want to most sincerely thank you and then add my voice on the need to express the gratitude of the entire community to you.
Also in the month of March, Professor Babagana Umara commissioned a newly constructed Borno Investment House located around the popular post office area in Maiduguri, the state capital. The company has been operating in a rented building since it commenced operation 35 years ago, now has a three-story building, spacious edifice. Commissioning the structure, Governor Zulum assured of continued support to reposition the company to enhance the economy of the state and eulogized the managing director of Borno Investment Company, Mohammed Bukar Umar, describing him as dedicated personality.
I wish to commission this beautiful edifice constructed by the Borno Investment Company to the benefit of humanity and to the glory of God. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
In that same March, Governor Zulum has been appreciated for empowering 1,488 members of Traders and Hand Workers Association around the post office area with 75.4 million naira to boost their businesses. Chairman of the Traders and Artisans, Ambassador Mohammed Mustafa Bachelu, conveyed the appreciation of 1,488 registered members of the association, stressing that all the members in the first list earlier submitted to the governor have benefited from the financial support of 50,000 naira each, totaling about 75.4 million naira. Similarly, during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umar Azulum chaired inaugural meeting of a technical working group under the Presidential Committee on Repatriation, Return and Resettlement of Displaced Persons in the Northeast, in Abuja. Addressing the meeting, Professor Umar Azulum charged members to put in their best for the successful repatriation of over 190 Nigerian refugees currently living in neighboring countries of Cameroon, Niger, and Chad as a result of insurgency, and urged the technical working groups to liaise with the Tripartite Committee on Repatriation of Nigerian Refugees.
I'm calling upon all of us to be dedicated enough to see how we can support our own Nigerians that are living outside our own country, that are eager to come back home.
Also in the month of March, Governor Babagana Umar Azulum was in Kirawa, Goza Local Government Area on assessment of reconstruction works ahead of resettling displaced persons in the Boda community. Governor Azulum had set up a committee chaired by the Commissioner for Housing and Energy, Engineer Saleh Vungas, charged with the mandate of resettling displaced communities of Kirawa and Gushi Town, both in Goza Local Government Area. Professor Azulum, during the assessment visit, announced 50,000 naira cash with food and non-food items to each of the male returnees, while their wives received 10,000 naira and textile material each. He also assured those whose houses have not been rebuilt will receive 100,000 naira cash to each household and other intervention to enable them rebuild their homes. Professor Zulum enjoined Goza communities to support the military with useful information that will help in ending the insurgency.
Jama, insha Allah, murake Allah, kuma Allah ba mu lafiya. Amma jama mu hankali. Kar wannan abu da ya same mu ta ya sake koma wurin mu. Wani Allah ne yana yi amma akwai sanadin shi. Ai hankali a kula da jama'an tsaro. Ai hankali a hada kai da su biyar gefiyar. Ai hankali ina cikin kwakwa da ba su da hali mai kyau. A bayyana. Ai hankali a cikin kwakwa wanda kusan yara kwakwa a daji yanzu ba ku sani. Ai musu magana. Ba zuwa nan garin ba ne kar a zo nan garin a ce
While in Goza, Governor Babagana Umar Azulum visited the multinational joint task force based in Kirawa and commended their gallantry, also assured of continuous support of Borno State government to their well-being at the front line. The Commander Multinational Joint Task Force showed Governor Azulum bicycles and motorcycles recovered from the insurgents between Sambisa Forest and Mandara.
Let me first and foremost commend the Cameroonian officers and men under the tutelage of the Multinational Joint Task Force and that of the Nigerian Armed Forces of their efforts in ensuring the re-establishment of Kirawa town. So far, so good, we have seen the level of construction. Although we can't say we have achieved the desired objective, but I think the best way we can go forward is to see how we can support the communities so that they can come and rebuild their houses by themselves.
Also in the month of March, Professor Babagana Umara was at the Ramat Polytechnic Maiduguri and commissioned two blocks of hostel with 1,500 bed space, renovated and re-equipped by the Ministry of Higher Education, Science, Technology and Innovation, with funds generated internally from the Polytechnic's commercial activities. The Governor commended the Commissioner for Higher Education, Science, Technology and Innovation, Dr. Babagana Mustafa Malumbe, for wonderfully improving fortunes of the Polytechnic, but outrightly rejected naming of the hostel in his honor.
Let me also use this opportunity to commend the Honorable Commissioner for what he did within the last 6 months. I've directed the Borno State Geographic Information System to liaise with the Ministry of Higher Education with a view to looking into the possibility of extending many bus spaces that are behind Government College Yerwan, other so that Ramat Batakana will become picking up. Well, it is my singular honor and privilege to commission this project to the glory of God and to the benefit of humanity. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Similarly, during the month under review, Governor Zulum was at the Bolo Resthouse, a popular commercial area in Maiduguri, and disbursed 62,750,000 naira to laborers as part of counter-insurgency measures. The social and economic support is aimed at enhancing livelihood and building resilience of citizens. Of the 846 beneficiaries, each of the 409 elderly low-income earners were presented with 100,000 naira cash, totaling 40.9 million naira, while each of the 439 young laborers received 50,000 naira cash, made up of 387 men and 50 women, totaling 21.8 million naira.
I want the opportunity that I have in. I would like to do that one day, yeah.
Also in the month of March, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum was in Abuja to commemorate the 5th anniversary of the Northeast Children Trust Learning Center, hosted by the Vice President Yemi Osinbajo, founder of the Learning Center. Held at the NAF Conference Center, had in attendance Senator Kashim Shettima, the First Lady Dr. Falmata Umara Zulum, and National Assembly members. Addressing the gathering, Professor Osinbajo reaffirmed support to children affected by insurgency in the Northeast and commended effort of Governor Zulum, who state host the Northeast Children Trust Learning Center, and other governors of the region, saying Zulum took over from his dynamic predecessor, Senator Kashim Shettima, and continued exceptionally well.
Governor Zulum simply took over without missing a beat, and since then, he's done incredible work in not just promoting the work of the center, but also in advancing it. As we've been told, over 100 of those children, I think there are 173 of them, are now in secondary school. The governor, Governor Zulu, deserves every commendation for the revolutionary work that's going on there, for the great work that he's doing.
In a remark, Governor Zulum showered encomiums on the Vice President for his foresight in establishing the Learning Center, which the governor said is making huge impact in basic education and vocational skills to orphans, in addition to accommodating, feeding, and providing them with medical care.
The celebration, 5th celebration anniversary of the Northeast Children Trust Learning Center in Maiduguri. Let me once again use this opportunity to applaud the vision of Mr. Vice President of establishing this very important school in Borno State. One very important aspect of this learning center is in its curriculum development. In addition to providing intensive literacy and numeracy to the children, this school also offers strong technical and vocational education to the pupils. It offers strong digital literacy to the children. And I think this is the type of education that we are looking for, because it will make the children to become self-reliant.
The governor lamented on the high number of orphans and widows in the Northeast and appealed to well-meaning Nigerians to contribute towards reducing the hardship of such vulnerable fellow Nigerians by investing on charity schools in Borno and other areas in the Northeast. Similarly, in the month of March, President Muhammadu Buhari met with governors of All Progressive Congress, APC, at the State House ahead of a hate-free national convention. The president expressed gratitude to all the governors, called for a continued partnership and fortified alliances, saying, "Formation of the All Progressive Congress about 9 years ago was mainly for national salvation with unshakable resolve, patriotic and noble motivation, which led to the party's victory at the 2015 general elections and urged critical stakeholders to maintain the tempo." President Buhari said the APC chose its leadership through consensus and pleaded for same at the national convention with the spirit of democracy, the party's constitutions and constitutions of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, stressing the need to stop frivolous and diversionary litigation when reconciliation processes are available for settling dispute whenever arises. He said they must restore sanity and purpose in affairs of the party and lead the APC to victory and have a stronger and more united country. Governor Babagana Umara said the All Progressive Congress APC is the only political party that remain united with quality deliverance of infrastructures and human capital development since it assumed leadership in 2015. This came to the fore at the first ever pre-convention political conference in Nigerian's history, organized by the ruling party, the APC.
Prior to the advent of this administration, particularly in Borno State, about 22 local government areas in Borno State, out of the 27 local government areas, are under the control of the insurgents. Particularly in Borno State, out of about 6 major roads that we have in the state, at a time we had only one major road which is open to commuters to fly, which is the road between Maiduguri to Kano. All other roads in Borno State are closed completely. So you can imagine the cumbersome nature of what we had before. But fortunately enough, all our roads are now completely open. None of the 27 local government areas are under the control of Boko Haram. Two of the local government areas that are not occupied by human population will soon be occupied.
Also in the month of March, Governor Babagana Umara Zulum was in Wilton Park, Sussex, United Kingdom, on invitational visit and addressed multinational conference of Lake Chad countries and development partners. The conference focused attention on how to effectively manage the mass surrenders by Boko Haram and ISWAP fighters through disarmament, demobilization and reintegration, tagged Lake Chad Basin, Key Steps Towards Comprehensive Regional Solutions, was hosted by the UK's Foreign, Commonwealth and Development Office, United Kingdom. Governor Zulum spoke on insurgency, recovery and rebuilding Borno State, my aspirations for Borno State and Lake Chad region, highlighted the impact of the insurgency in Borno in terms of infrastructure destructions, displacements, humanitarian crisis, and resettlement efforts. He explained Borno's immediate and long-time plans for stabilization and development, as well as how the state is responding to the mass surrender of over 35,000 repentant fighters from Boko Haram and ISWAP.
There's no country in the whole world where insurgency has ended with kinetic efforts alone. There's always been a product of kinetic and non-kinetic means, trust and confident building measures and addressing the past concerns. The reconciliation and integration, the key to success in our period is trust, confidence in the system of accountability, ensuring that innocent victims are not punished throughout. Those are great fields of social justice, and the repentance is all at the end of the time. Our vision is the aspiration of over 6 million of our citizens. And our judgment what about the state is a secure, competitive, agri business and commercial hub anchored on prosperous, dignified people and sustainable development. to achieve this vision over the next 10 years through the participatory approach is to define what we must work on individually and collectively to build and sustain by 2030 a self-reliant government with over 70% of the population by 2030.
Professor Babagana Umara also highlighted the recent effort by the Nigerian government with President Muhammadu Buhari's appointment of a presidential committee on repatriation, return and resettlement of displaced persons in the Northeast, saddled with the responsibility of resettling IDPs, supporting successful repatriation of over 190 Nigerians refugees and managing mass surrender of insurgents.